Investment refers to an instrument utilized by individuals for distributing their funds with the point of generating income. A good investment program is in line with investors' goals and has all the benefits of a successful investment. Every investor must consider some points in choosing an investment option. Each feature of investment varies in terms of the degree of risk or benefits, and investors choose the one that's worth suitability. Features of investment program plays an efficient role within the overall improvement of the economy through utilizing the investment funds of group of people for improvement and beneficial means. An incredible investment strategy is one that's in line with investors' objectives. It ought to provide all the benefits of a proven investment. So, if it's not so much trouble choosing an investment choice, you must consider a few points. Let's talk about those 8 essential features of investment program. First is safety of principle. This refers to the protection or preservation of the capital invested. This does not necessarily mean that the market prices of one's investment never shrink below their cost, but it means that the investors must avoid unsound and profitless risk. This may take the form of investing companies with track record of earnings and sound management. In short, this calls for a careful review of the economic and industry trends before choosing types of investment or the time to invest. Sometimes, investors are carried away by the promise of a very large returns, and in considering this possibility, they forget about the safety of the capital invested. The term principal safety refers to the security of principal against any potential loss as a result of changing circumstances below the expected level at any time. Security funds invested is one of the essential fixing of great investment program. So, safety of principal means assurance against any possible loss under the changing conditions and can be accomplished through a cautious review of economic and industrial patterns before choosing the type of investment. It is clear that no one can make an instead of future financial conditions with most extreme accuracy. Second is adequate liquidity of investment and collateral value. This means that one's investment should have the capacity to be sold for cash or to be borrowed on the full value without delay, and that it could be used as collateral in times of emergencies. Stocks and bonds are liquid investment, while real estate assets are less liquid. Liquid investment is one which can be changed over into cash instantly without money-related misfortune or loss. Liquid investment also offer assistance to investors when they meet crisis or if there's an emergency. Stocks are easily marketable, as it were, when they give adequate return through dividends and capital appreciation. The investors contribute in high grade and promptly sellable invested in order to assure their liquidity and collateral value. What is collateral value? So it is a fair market value or the amount of asset that have been put up to secure a loan. As I said a while back, that real estate assets are less liquid. So most investors favor liquid investment simply because a liquid asset is referenced to cash on hand or an asset that can be quickly converted to cash due to its capacity to be quickly assessed. Third is the stability of income or regular income stream. This means that the investing public may look up to their investments as a supplementary source of cash flow, especially if the investor depends closely on their income of the business. Hence, the investment should have stable income. Most investors hope to get a regular return on their investment, which they may consider satisfactory. This only means that before investing in a certain firm, the investor should do a little assessment of the circumstances. As an example, because of our country's economic situation, there's a chance that the firm invested in will happen as well. So, before placing your funds through investment, every investor should review or analyze everything to obtain a consistent return or stability of income that may be considered satisfying. Is the purchasing power stability. This means that the principal and income from the investment should have stable ability to purchase goods and services in times of inflation. Here, the investor should carefully study the degree of price level inflation they expect, possibilities of gain and loss in the investment, and limitation imposed by personal and family considerations. In short, investors need to ensure that the return on their investment is consistent so that they can still make purchases goods and services or the products they wish to buy during the inflation current time. That even if the value of the certain products and services increases, investors could still acquire them since they have stable purchasing power. Fifth is the adequacy of income after taxes. Here, an investor is concerned with the amount of income paid by the investment and with the burden of income taxes upon that income. Investors oftentimes choose types of investment whose income is still enough even after taxes to it have been paid. So, investing can be a great way to grow the assets so when it comes in paying your taxes or their taxes, they can still receive a return at the end of the day. Is possible capital appreciation, an investment feature wherein the value of investment could possibly increase as years pass by. Hence, investors can profit by choosing carefully, buying at the right time and going from overpriced to underpriced items. This is the probability of buying an asset cheap and turning it around for a profit after a reasonable holding period. Some investors are not as much concerned with immediate income but look for sound companies which are expected to have a larger normal growth over a 5 to 10 year period. So capital appreciation means to the increase of market price of an investment. It is also calculated at the time of disposal of an investment as a difference between the sale price and purchase price of an investment. So it may occur in a variety of investments such as equity securities, mutual funds, real estate, gold and other commodities, or tradable investments. Next is freedom from care. This means that investment needs constant skilled supervision of the investor to avoid losses and to obtain better return. Hence, maximum commitment is required. Where the investor does not actually manage the investment, he employs counselor or management services of a trust company. In my own understanding, freedom from care means that we need to have a close supervision of the skills of the investor so that we will avoid bankruptcy and that we will gain better return of our investment. It is also a must to commit oneself in the business. The investor does not only invest but he also have to put trust in the company. Last is legality. The investment must be complete or absolute in legal compliance requirements approved by law. This means that the investor should have a legal document approved by the law. Investments always come with some kind of risk which cannot be fully avoided. However, you can minimize it by using these features. This is all from my side regarding features of investments.